everyone. Jason Shepard here of MzeroA.com, flying the airplane that kind of started it all for MzeroA.com over a decade ago. That is 512 Romeo. I'm beam my touchdown point for runway 14. Carport power's coming back. I'm turning my base for 14 now. Williston traffic. 512 Romeo is turning left base runway 14, full stop, Williston. Turn this on in here now. I want to show you something a little different. I had a scenario happen to me about 3 or 4 years ago where I was flying an RG airplane. The taxi out, everything was great. And all of a sudden, as I was about to bring the, just took off, I went to tap the brakes and the brakes went to the floor and I had no brakes. Now, the airport I was going to ended up having 8,000 feet of runway, so I wasn't too terribly worried about it. But
traffic number 49005, taking off runway 5, Williston traffic.
And Williston traffic, Cessna 512 Romeo's turning final, runway 14, Williston traffic. And it brought up an interesting point, though. I told the story that people wondered what would happen if I landed the airplane without any brakes. Well, that's exactly what I'm going to show you here today. I'm final for 14. I'm going to even purposely come in a little bit faster than normal here, just 10 knots faster, nothing major. Get my last notch of flaps. And when I touch down, I'm going to not touch the brakes. I'm just going to let the airplane roll. Honestly, if you fly a tail dragger airplane off the grass, this is what you do most of the time. So you just let the airplane roll. So I want to show you what it's like to just let that airplane roll and see how the airplane naturally wants to come to a stop. If it's at idle, assuming you're properly at idle, absolutely on its own.
5 miles, R&F5, full stop, Williston.
And we're coming on in. Runway is ours. Everyone from 5 is out of way. Power's back to idle.
From runway 5, Williston traffic.
Ooh, good little gust there. And setting her down real nice and just letting it roll. I'm not going to touch the brakes. I'm not even touching the flaps. I'm just going to let it roll. And you can see when I was landing with no brakes, my greatest challenge wasn't stopping the airplane. My greatest challenge with no brakes was finding how to clear and get off the runway, because you don't realize that little bit of brake you use. But as you can see, we're slowing down. We're coming to a stop here. The airplane naturally is going to slow down. Don't let an issue like not having brakes become an issue. Honestly, if you're really getting a jam, I'm going to grab the brakes here now. If you're really getting a jam, you can add a little drag to the equation there too by opening up a door. Again, it seems like such a simple, such an easy video, but you'll be thankful next time you've practiced such a thing. Just land long one day and let it roll. It's better for your brakes that way anyways. I can't wait to read your comments below this video on Facebook, on YouTube, on MzeroA.com. Enjoy the rest of your day, and most importantly, remember, a good pilot is always learning. Have a great day, guys. We'll see you.
I sincerely hope you loved watching this video. These videos you see online are simply just the tip of the iceberg of what we do here at MzeroA.com. MzeroA is a complete private, instrument, commercial, and FOI online ground school. Everything is done at your own pace online. You watch our lessons, also online, take practice exams, all from any device. If you love these free videos we put out here on YouTube and Facebook, I encourage you to check out our complete online ground school for the knowledge test, check ride, and most importantly, setting you up to make you that safe real-world pilot. Take a 2-week free trial, no strings attached, of our online ground school by visiting mzeroa.com/trial.